Alright, so at the top of the turn, we have a benefactor here, a candidate for adoption from Richard Fitzgilbert, a strict governor, proponent of feudal law, Christian, confident commander, and he's positive. I like him. So let's find him. Where is he? I didn't even get his name. Gasp. Nope. Richard Fitzgilbert. Where was he?
I don't know.
Oh, we'll just find him in here. This was him. He's in Northampton. Oh, he was given Northampton, it looks like. Okay. Well, you're pretty decent. What places do not have governors? I'll look for one and then I'll get back to you. Okay, Oxanaford doesn't have a governor, actually, so...
And I'll do.
Let's have him head over that way.
That's it.
He can be the,
finished for the day.
Lord of Oxanaford. Alright, so let's work on the east here. Alright, so here I can recruit my own spearmen. Now, the population is significant here. So we're actually going to build two batches of spearmen, and hopefully that's going to calm them down. Of course, this will come down to the amount of unrest. We'll wait till they're built, though, before we move out my only garrison. Alright, so Gipswick here, we're going to... Ooh, we can assault it right away, so we're going to just maintain the siege real quick. Actually, I don't need that cavalry just right now. What do they have? I'm not too sure. I don't think it's all that significant. So, what the hey? Let's assault it. Yeah. Alright, so assault. So who is it? Peasants and Soaksmen. Oh, this is going to be a slaughter. I love it. Alright, I'll see you on the battle map. Alright, so I thought I'd try something a little different. I have like a little column formation here. So we're going to march into town and kill us a bunch of peasants and Soaksmen. Hey, look. There's some right now. Whoops, I didn't press the record button. Okay, we're going to actually run them down with my cavalry before they get to the center. My archers are also giving them the business too. Let's just have them take fire at will for now so we don't hit my horses as they come. I'll give you a little close-up of this. Yeah, you better run, buddy. Buddies. Oh, are they gonna make it? No, they're not gonna make it. Not even close. Alright, so the rest of the Soaksmen are clamored up in here, it looks like. I think that's two units of them. I think so. Alright, so yeah, let's march up our giant column of death. Oh, their leader was in that. That's sad. That's sad to see. Alright, let's see here. Yes, that's good for that bit of column. And I'll just rearrange these things and I'll get back to you when I get closer. Alright, so I'm going to set things up a little differently. First of all, let's see if I have range. Okay, so I do have range there with those archers. Now, they're not on fire at will yet. And they won't go on fire at will until I'm all set. So I'm going to assume that they're going to send in their men this way towards these archers. So I'm going to send my regular troops that way and my more elite troops this way. I'll, peel off a couple mercenary horses this way, a couple this way. So if they decide to come out and charge this way, I'll swing around with this flank, and if they come after these guys, I'll push in with this flank. Pretty simple. What I do like to do when I have a little more time or patience is actually set up men like more further around here, and then you have like a full surround effect, which makes them break pretty easily. But I want to try just a single front, one, because I'm lazy, and two, because I want to see what it looks like. So once they get in place, good enough. These guys still have to get in place, but they will soon, so let's give them the order to let loose with their arrows. We'll watch a giant wall of pointy sticks hit these guys, and they'll come out, and I'll countercharge, and all will be hunky-dory. I'll get a bunch of free kills in the meantime. Now, these guys are also on skirmish mode, which will be a nice benefit. But let's just bring these guys up nice and close so they don't have to charge as far. Nice and close. There we go. So which way are they gonna go, do you think? I think they're, looks like they're coming right for here. And they're taking their time too. Which just lets me kill more of them. Wonderful. We're going to have them go with one more volley. Maybe. Hey, what do you know? That was easy. End battle. No casualties. That was very successful. I'll see you back at the campaign map. Now what do? I don't occupy them. Because they have, well, it looks like they have probably about 7,000 to 8,000. Man, because I can kill about 5,000 of them. Helmham here does have a significant population already. I could enslave them. But I don't know. I still do kind of need some troops, don't I? Slave or lay to waste? Enslave to lay or lay to waste? I really can't decide either way. So when I can't decide, I always think, you know, who's leading my army, and that's William. And he's a tyrant, and he's laid tons of towns to waste. So he'll do that to this one, too. So, we'll do that. We could go with feudal lordship, but we'll wait a moment. We'll go with local lordship instead. All those dead people. Oh well. Yeah, and there's still about 2,000. And the population growth rate is huge. So, we'll be okay. Yeah, because these guys have about 3 grand. I guess I could have enslaved them. Oh well. Lessons learned for next time. I'm doing pretty well as far as troop population. And if I keep it kind of low, well then I wouldn't have to... Ooh, horse farmer. Then I wouldn't have to worry about public order. Because once you get more people, well then you have to control them, right? Okay. So, that's that. Now let's see how much of my army I can move out. None. I probably don't want to. But let's quickly...
By your will,
sir. Ooh, there's another one. Okay, there's another large town. Maybe I'll just enslave these people instead. Okay, so we're gonna just meet up here.
By your will, senor.
And...
We shall camp here.
Build... Oh yeah, we already did the local lordship. Okay. Oh, I can recruit mercenary ferdmen here already. But they're expensive. Too expensive for a garrison. So we'll worry about them later. Okay, so here in the north, looks like someone's trying to organize a small army or so. They're not really much of a threat compared to my giant stack. So we're going to just build ourselves a watchtower, keep an eye across the bridge there, and head right... We're going to actually park my guys right here at this intersection. Build ourselves a little camp, and hold out and wait till we take this... and a chunk of over here, and then once William's done here, we'll use those forces, and I think we'll probably push up north along the coast. It's probably our best bet. And as we can see, I control now 21 provinces, and I need 40 to win, so including a bunch of these ones. I've gotten most of them, not all of them though, so we'll have to focus on that, but I only have about 19 territories to go. Alright, so I have some reinforcements coming, so let's just drop these guys off here. They'll head here to Wincaster and probably further east. I recruited more dudes over here, which I could send over, but maybe not just yet. We'll have these guys. They can meet up here, can't they? They could actually make it to the fight. Let's do that then. Do that. Perfect. And we'll launch an attack then. Because we have more than enough men to take this town. So I'll see you. Oh, wait. Actually, we'll just double check. Yeah, just three things of light furred. Three units of light furred. Against Henry de Farrar and his giant army. So I'll see you on the battle map yet again. Alright, so we're going to start the battle. Sure enough, we're going to move up my archers here, so they have a line of attack right there. allow them run. And once we push the light Ferd here from the wall, we'll bring out the spearmen, smash them through, then I'll bring in probably the rest of my spearmen to do their thing and just swarm over and kill these guys. So let's just, I'll give you a few shots of these light Ferd not knowing what the heck to do and getting shot by a plethora of arrows. I'm not killing too many. Oh, there they go. So let's see where the other two units are. They're probably at the center. One is, for sure. I wonder where the other one is. Oh. Here. I see. This one's still getting its shot at. So. Okay, well, you've seen this plan many times, so I'll get back to you once we get into some more exciting bits. So, you know that pile of Ferdmen that were hanging by the gates? Yeah, they're all dead. So I'm going to burst down the wall. They're retreating to the town center, so I'll get set up for another attack, and I'll get back to you. Alright, so I'm setting myself up a little double-winged envelopment here. I have 4 units of spearmen and some archers here on this flank, and 3 units of spearmen, a few archers, and my leader, my general here, Henri de Ferrat. I think that's Henri, I can't remember. And my monks over here. Now, unlike the last tactic with the Soaksmen, these are light furred and they have missile units. So as soon as I goad them out with my archers, I'm going to want to charge ahead with my spearmen as to limit the casualties that I would sustain with them. So let's just quickly time speed this ahead so my archers get into position. And as soon as they're all set, I'll let loose with them. Come on. There we go. Backspace on them. Alright, so let's let loose. We're going to just keep an eye on see where they go. And, yeah, like I said, charge ahead once they get out of that town square. Because we don't want to, okay, looks like they're going to the right. Nope, looks like they're going both ways. Perfect! That is very convenient for me. So, this unit is pretty much out, so we're going to go ahead and charge forward these men. We're going to wait a few more before these guys get out, though. There we go, that should be good enough. So we're going to take my archers that are over here. Nope, those are my spearmen. Where are my archers? No, they got lost in here. You know what? We'll just take them. Oh, this. Take them all off of fire at will now. Don't want to hit my own guys in the back, after all. Charge ahead. And this should be over in a flash, I'm hoping. Whoa, that's one heck. Here, we'll take this spare one that's around here. Have them circle around this way. Oh no, these guys are retreating to the town square. Curses. Okay, well that's fine. We'll deal with their one bit first, and then we'll deal with the other ones. So we gotta make sure we really want to surround these guys then. There we go. Look at all that yellow. Norman yellow versus English brown. Ugh, gross. Oh no! They got me. Oh, those bastards. I got too close to them still. Oh, that's it. It's smashing time. Okay, so let's bring my general here. My monks here. There we go. Do that. Hopefully these guys will break soon. And do I have a clear shot at the backs of these guys? I kinda do. What are you doing, dude? No, don't skirmish. You fool. Nope. I think we got their leader. Aha, we did. Excellent. Excellent. So now we can get behind these guys. Get all set up. Maybe we'll do a little charge, too, for the heck of it. Come on, run. There you go. Yeah, I get you guys in there. There. There we go. So now it should just be a matter of time. And let's do a charge, a heroic little charge into them. Wham! That's handy. Okay, good on ya. So now they're surrounded. Of course they won't break, they will fight to the death, because some of them did get in there. But, what can you do? So I lost probably a unit's worth of... Whoa, where are you going? What did I do? I must have pressed something, because these guys are... That was weird. Oh well. Anyways, I probably lost a unit's worth of men. Probably, once this will be all said and done. I'm gonna leave my guys in here until I lose one. Now we'll pull them out now. Oh yeah, there we go, I did lose one. Now, don't want to lose too many. I wouldn't want to lose my general due to some lucky hit of a spear now, would I? Well, you guys aren't doing anything. Head on over here. Okay, well, this is pretty much a guaranteed result, so I'll see you at the result screen. There we go, so 649 kills, 197 losses, so just a little bit more than one unit of men there, but it was worth it taking this town in one turn rather than having to wait them out. So I'll see you back at the campaign map. Okay, so that is... Whoa, they're building a whole lot of ships around here too, weren't they? Good thing I took it. Anyways, we're going to enslave this populace, because I definitely do need men around this area. So we're going to say enslave. Of course, they're all upset. Whoa, what's this? Marcher lordship. That's new. Oh. No feudal lordship. Marcher. Okay, what's this? A Norman lord granted a marcher lordship will establish a moat and bailey castle on a prominent hill. May be removed, and a local or feudal lordship replace it at any time, though it will take some years to create a new lordship. Only feudal lordships may be built on the continent. Only marcher lordships may be built on historical marcher provinces bordering Wales and Alba. Ah! Neat. Okay, let's do that. Let's lower the tax rate, do that, and that should be enough to calm them down. We'll have to recruit some garrison here as well. Well, we'll deal with that next session. I think that was a pretty good session, actually. I nicked one... What was it? One... Two territories this session. Pretty good. So I only have 18 left to go.